and TT. What's going on, y'all? Welcome to Ruffled Feathers Podcast. D, what about them Packers, man?
Man, you know I ain't no Packers fan, but I see they did their thing, 32-18. NFC Championship bound. Let's see what they gonna do.
Man, all right.
Straight, though.
All right. Fuck that. Let's talk
about Lori Hart. Man, fuck that weak ass bitch.
That's how you feel, man.
I mean, it is what it is.
She only smashed like 5, 6, 7, or 8 of them. What's the problem?
Come on, man. Stop it.
Why she had to fuck them? Because she was dating them?
Of course.
Come on now.
Who are you
talking
about?
For real.
I mean, shit. The team, I guess.
What's the team?
I think it was just Diddy and Diddy's son, and I know Michael B. Jordan.
Damn, the father and the son?
Yeah, the
man.
Father and the son. I think
yeah,
that was in that too.
Man, that's rough.
And
I know it was Future. Who else
Royal? Don't matter.
The dad, the son, and
that might have been it. That ain't no hoe. That's a hoe.
Right.
Y'all do it every day. So if y'all do it, then it's okay.
But if a female do it, then y'all
I mean, you know,
a woman body,
y'all body sacred, man.
But
you know, y'all
who supposed... said she fucked them?
All of our bodies should be sacred.
Them niggas having money. I'm sure she fucked
them.
So now you saying she fucked them for some money?
I'm saying they having money, so I'm sure she fucked. I'm sure she fucked them. They having money.
Facts.
Because they having money.
Right. Mm-hmm. That don't mean
she
nothing.
Has money.
They got more money. All of them. All of them got more money.
Right. I don't think that was a factor, though, for real. Even looking back at some of those stories, I don't think money was a factor. I think she was really genuinely getting to know them. And if they was on some bullshit, she just let it go.
Sound like my life.
Facts.
Oh, sound like your life, huh?
Not to a certain extent, but...
I mean, I look at
nobody gonna wait around and play. What you gonna keep?
Can't
sitting?
Compare no hoe with no boss.
Right, you right, fam.
Hey, I ain't gonna judge Lori Harvey. You know, I just look at it like that ain't gonna be wifey material. But I mean, hey, you know.
Hey, a lot of niggas turn their hoes into housewives.
That's actually preferred.
I ain't gonna say all that, but you right though. You right, but I ain't gonna say all that. You right.
But why do women have to date one man at a time? Why is that?
I just think that women are custom to do that. I mean,
why?
Classy women is custom to do that.
Oh, she got to be classy to date one man at a time.
So if she a hoe, then what?
Ain't no hoes going to date no one man at a time.
Mm. She's trying to have that variety.
So what if she's just trying to get to know them genuinely, but... they not having sex. They just going on dates. What's wrong with that? So she's a hoe if she goes on more.
Oh, no. She can go on dates. But when you having sex with multiple men.
Who says she's having sex? That's the point.
If she go on a date. Well, you know, some people going to assume. But if she know she ain't did nothing, that's all that matter. People can assume. People can assume all they want. She know she ain't did nothing. That's all that matter at the end of the day. But what I'm saying is women, classy women, is custom to only dealing with one man. Meaning like for our sex. Now, women might go on dates with 20 different men. It'd be no problem.
It's no problem. So she's not going to be a hoe.
Oh, she ain't no hoe. She going on dates. But if she fucking 20 different men, definitely.
So, okay, we can put this in perspective with Lori Harvey. People mm-hmm. are looking at her, and a lot of men are feeling like she's a hoe. Mm-hmm. They don't even know the backstory to that. Yeah. No one has ever confirmed that they had sex with her.
That's true.
They just seen them on some dates, seen them on pictures together.
Listen, ladies, y'all might have a point. Y'all might have a point.
We do.
Y'all might have a point. But it don't look good.
It's the way it looks.
It don't look good for Lori Harvey.
So when you guys do it, that look good. When y'all got different women, taking pictures with different women, y'all texting different women, even on Facebook and things like that, y'all commenting on different women's pages, y'all liking, loving everything, that's all good.
Well, I don't like a damn thing. I don't take pictures and I don't love this.
But they could say that you that way too, because a lot of men that got a lot to hide, they don't have a social media too.
Listen, it's a reason for that though.
What's the reason?
It ain't got nothing to do with no sneaky shit. It's just that some niggas like to be out the way. You don't want that exposure. What's already understood don't need to be explained. Period. I ain't trying to impress nobody, because I already know what my stance is.
Period. All right, so I got a question. Okay. So niggas feel like women don't bring enough to the table. It's a whole lot of shady memes out there right now. Right. Why?
You know, I mean,
I know you post all the memes. You the one do it.
About women don't bring enough to the table?
All kind of memes about women. Shady. You shady boots.
I just be doing it for entertainment, though. You shady boots. I just be doing it for entertainment. You know, y'all know I be entertaining, you know, so.
Well, why do y'all feel like that, though?
I think it's a lot of women that bring stuff to the table. It's a lot of independent women. It's a lot of women got their own bag, you know, that bring stuff to the table. I'm not going to say that women, like, it ain't a lot of women that bring stuff to the table, because I believe it is. It's just that it's a lot of women that got low self-esteem, so that a lot of them lower they self to deal with a certain type of man, you know, and that's where everything go wrong at, to me. That's my opinion, you know.
Okay, so what would be bringing something to the table? What would y'all consider, even y'all, what do y'all consider bringing something to the table as a woman?
I mean, to me, when you know what I'm saying, like, you can't ask for something and you can't bring it. So, like, meaning what? That be able to bring something to the table besides face and ass. Like, I'm just being for real, though. Like, you know, everybody got these high expectations, but, like, what is we really doing? You know what I'm saying? Like, if you want to go, if you know you ain't never, ever been to Red Lobster day in your life, don't be hollering about you want to go to Red Lobster when you know you're an Applebee hoe. I'm just saying.
Applebee, maybe she want to try something new.
Well, why she can't just volunteer to try something new? Like, I want to take you out.
9 times out of 10, if she'll eat at Applebee's, she'll eat at Red Lobster. I'm really liking the same.
Nowadays they is. But back in the day.
Applebee's good.
But back in the day.
I like Applebee's better than Red Lobster, personally.
Well, yeah, Applebee's is straight, but Applebee's just ain't nothing you're going to take nobody to on the first date. If she say she want to go to Applebee's, that's cool. But if you already rocking with them already, you probably ain't gonna suggest Applebee's. I'm thinking. I mean, no. If it's a new date, you're not gonna suggest Applebee's. But if you already with them already, then you might go to Applebee's.
Right.
I mean, but the first date, you're going to put a little twist on it, because you want to take her somewhere where it's going to be like, okay, cool, so you can solidify the situation, in a sense.
All right. Well, then, since y'all say that, in order of importance, sex, intelligence, money, looks.
Intelligence, I will say is first.
Second? It's fourth.
Okay, you said sex.
Intelligence, money, looks.
I say intelligence first. I would say,
let's be realistic.
Sex. I'm gonna say intelligence, gonna money, look, sex for me.
Yeah.
I agree. Yeah. I agree with looks, intelligence, money.
You just keeping it real for yourself.
And sex. I'm just keeping it real for everybody.
Keep it pee.
Because you gotta have, it's gotta be something that's appealing in order to get the conversation going. Yeah. Because you're not gonna wanna just talk, I mean, just, I'm gonna say just for me, you know what I mean? I can't speak for everybody in the room, but I'm just saying though, like, I gotta see something first, and then I gotta see what's going on up here, then I can kinda go from there. You know what I mean? Because I'm trying to get, now I can get to know you, because I'm comfortable with getting to know you.
That might be from a male's perspective. I think for me, everybody don't look. It's not a look thing for me. I think a lot of men especially don't have a look all the way together all the time. But sometimes they're, you know, charismatic, and that works for me sometimes too, though. So it hasn't always been about looks, but that's a bonus.
Right. Yeah, I have to say conversation. So that's why I say intelligence.
Yeah.
Because a conversation would turn me completely off.
Well, I look at it like this. You ain't got to be no damn beauty queen, but shit, you gotta be at least be presentable.
I think it's
so it's yeah. But I look at but you back in the day it used to be more so looks. But as you get older, you know what I'm saying? I'm down there 40. You know what I'm saying? Like it's other things you looking for first. You know what I'm saying?
Man.
Yeah, man, you know, it's other... Hey, listen, you got... Hey, listen, I look at it like this shit. I gotta know you're gonna be a motherfucker that's gonna push my wheelchair around if I gotta get in one day.
Well, what if she looking too good? I don't know if she gonna really be pushing that wheelchair.
I mean...
As long as I'm pushing it from the streets, you go to jail. <I'm out of here.
laughs> Damn.
Damn.
Crazy, man.
Well, we always say, bro, we gotta know if she gonna be able to wipe that ass if need be.
Yeah, right.
Or if it come down to the come down.
But you know what, though? I ain't like that. At least if you can't wipe this shit, you gonna have to have a motherfucker here, pay a motherfucker to wipe it or something. Somebody gotta do it.
Long as we doing it from the streets. Like I said, I ain't doing no more bids with nobody, so... I don't care how much I love you.
One time for big meat.
Well, no, can I say this though? When women say conversation is a lot. Okay. A lot, even talking to your friends, sometimes I know on the woman's perspective, they don't have a lot going on and they really think their conversation is everything. And I'm speaking for the men, I guess. But a lot of women think because they go to work every day or because they work here, they do a whole lot of complaining when they on the phone with men. They talk about all their problems. I think that's a turn off.
Yes,
but a lot of people think they are great conversationalists, and they're not.
You put a lot of y'all on blast.
No, for real. Like, because sometimes I don't want to hear that as a friend, you know? Yeah, right. And I'm friend enough to say, hey, what you got good going on? You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to be around for just the bad times. You know, I don't want to be that friend.
And a lot of niggas don't want to hear that negative all the time.
It's
either.
A turn off. Yes. It's an absolute turn off. Yeah. And I think that's enough to make a woman want to boss themselves up. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to come to this man talking about A, B, and C going on wrong in my life. Right. I need to have some things to talk about. A lot of women really are boring and they don't know it.
Right.
Yeah. And a lot of women don't have true friends to let them know that. So. But I agree with you with intelligence for sure.
Yes.
Gotta be walking the mill, able. All right, Trill, you got that. So with that, men are allowed to have a certain type. Y'all can have a type, right? Women can't. The moment that we got a type, when I say it's a no for me, that's a crowd bumper, well, it's right? Why? Why do men get to have a type and women can't? Because come with y'all line and push all the way back.
I mean, listen.
Y'all be all the way fat. Like, really,
not
y'all
the
be
line and push back.
Like, y'all be having major flaws.
Listen,
but
women.
It's all right for y'all.
Women can't have a type. Y'all can have a type. What you mean?
Nah. Why y'all feel like you think you better than me?
It's sometimes, Tay, it's about how you say it. Like, I tell you all the time.
It's a no for me. Like,
Oh, okay. But what I'm saying is, if you say it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, look. Yeah, that's the whole thing. It's how you say it. You know what I'm saying? If you come in, if you say something to somebody, you kind of just when you come at somebody and say like it's a no for me, it's just kind of how you present it, how you bring it to them. You know, if you bring them in the wrong way, it's gonna look like damn, like she acting like she is and that. You know what I'm saying? Even though you know you is, but that's just what a man gonna think to himself. Like damn, like you ain't gotta come hard on me like that. You know what I'm saying?
I think beauty is in the eye of this beholder, right? So I don't think men are all a mess. You know, if my men really be bossed up, they might not look all the way to her, but that's attractive to me when you got your shit together, you know what, to a certain degree, then I can see. You know, the one that's all in the club, like, give me some bottles, give them whatever they drink, and that's not my type. But one would think so because he did all this rah-rah, but that's not my type.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I've never
all that flashy.
All the flashy stuff. Or you got a bankroll, you got all your money in your pocket. I appreciate a man with a credit card and a bank card. You know what I mean?
Right. Good credit.
I have to pull out no fat stack for me to feel like you that.
That's our thing. Good credit. What's your credit score?
I mean, I'm bad.
She definitely don't ask.
Yes.
That's a
y'all hear
that
it, right?
That is right. And, yes. Well, that's important. Yeah. That's important.
Y'all get married, this score ain't shit.
Yeah. Yours ain't shit. If I asked that, we had some type of conversation, I would hope.
Yes.
And
that's the conversation y'all probably gonna have in the club because I done seen her do it. Like, what's your credit score?
Yes, yeah, right to the point.
And he leave her alone for the rest of the night, so
yeah,
she
Tina,
already
that is
know
great.
What it is.
Yeah. So you know what you're doing.
Or at least tell me, shit, my credit wasn't all that. You know, a couple years ago, I did meet somebody that was big on credit. And he taught me some things. And I was very appreciative. I am to this day appreciative of that.
Right.
And I think that a lot of people stray away from that conversation. But I'm going to be 37 this year. I can't play like that.
Right. You know? That's facts.
Even, I know this is a turn off. Not a crowd pleaser, but men with, I think for women too, they have a lot of children. And you come with a lot of problems. Like,
yes.
You're always talking about all the problems you have, and you got a lot of kids, there's no room for me in that conversation.
And you ain't never got no damn babysitter.
Women don't have that problem.
Man, I think like, I think like this though, you know what I'm saying, to each his own, but I ain't dating you if you got more than two kids, I'm cool.
So you can say that. If I say something like that,
I'm going to
be put on a cross.
No, not necessarily. Never. Okay. Well, hey, we got our standards.
Oh, Trans, who is Tutu? Saying sounds like your mic is off.
What's the you? You don't want
me. Oh, I'm not Tutu.
Hey. Oh. Is that better? I think so.
Can you hear me?
Okay. Thank you, girl. They was about to leave me out here. They ain't trying to hear this real.
We ain't even realize it.
Yeah, because y'all right here with me.
Yeah.
So let's talk about a real topic.
Okay.
So men find women to take care of them. So easy for y'all to do that, right? Women, we don't have.
I don't know. I ain't never had no woman take care of me.
Me neither. I always been bossed up. I always got it out the mud. So, you know. I'm like a woman. You know how some women
okay,
say,
Biggie Smalls.
No, it ain't even nothing like that, though. It's just that at the end of the day, I always taught to handle my damn business. You know what I'm saying? Like, you trying to, you can't go depending on nobody because ain't no insurance with that.
Right. I feel you on that. But y'all know men that do find women to take care of them. Y'all can relate to that.
Yeah, definitely.
Why
does
that happen? Y'all, men, you don't find men to take care of women like that.
And then chicks be sitting well, they credit up, building them up.
Well, no. You do. Listen, this is the thing.
Exactly. Shut up.
Listen, I got
wait, flag on the play. You yes, said they do what? Say it again.
Chicks be bossing them up, fixing them up, basically to make them uptight for the next relationship. That's why I read energy right away. If I know you somebody that I'm not really gonna jam with, I'm not gonna put no energy into that relationship because that's what you're doing. Mm-hmm. You get them all the tools they need to be successful for the next relationship.
Okay, build Mika, what about the men that deal with women, right? And you take care of her, she ain't working, you putting her through school, you paying for everything.
How often does that happen?
Oh, right. It happens.
Let's be real.
Is it quiet?
Huh?
Is it quiet?
Right.
What you mean quiet?
Is it a whisper?
Oh, no, it happens. So meaning you didn't took care of her, put her through nursing school, sure. She didn't got her license, and all of a sudden she's talking to you.
Y'all always say, was y'all all born and then y'all all had like this talk before y'all all got in the streets? Like, because y'all all say this nursing thing.
Well, that's
all the nurses needed.
That's a lot of. I'm not saying all of them, but I'm saying I know a few dudes that didn't put their woman through school, took care of everything, and then once they was done, it was all of a sudden it was a thing where she was like, you know, she talking slick and she don't need them no more because she feel like she doing good now. She feel like she in a position she don't need them no more. So that definitely happens.
Yeah, I agree.
I know more of that happened than a woman taking care of a dude.
You wait.
Yeah, he have to take my mic for a second.
I don't know. Absolutely maybe. Hey,
not.
Maybe.
Absolutely
hey, listen,
not.
Maybe because majority of the dudes I hang
absolutely
around with is all on the boss type level.
And
you know
absolutely
what I'm saying? So maybe that's the reason. Maybe that's the reason.
I don't believe that.
No, I know some dudes that ain't doing good, but they women ain't taking care of them.
When I say take care, I mean like there's a woman. There's so many women that allow the men to sit in their home and not work. She literally takes care of everything. She giving this man money to make it look like he paying for stuff. She's taking care of everything.
Say
rent,
honestly,
all
I don't know personally. I don't know none that's like that. Now I'm not saying I'm not saying it couldn't be like that.
Do you
that
know men that take things from women?
When you say take things, what
take
do you
things
mean?
Knowing that they don't want to be in a serious relationship with them. Take things.
Oh yeah, I know. Yeah, I know.
All right, well then you right understand that's the same thing. Yeah.
Ain't the same
yes
thing.
Yes, you trying to play word games with me.
Ain't the same thing. Ain't the same thing.
Same thing.
Ain't that the same thing?
That's the same
hell
thing.
No.
If you're taking something from someone knowing that you don't want to be with them, You're wasting energy. Even if you have sex with her, you're taking a piece of her. You don't want to be with her. You knew what you wanted to do when you got with
her. I'm not saying that's right to do, Tay, but I'm saying it's not the same as...
You know people that do it.
Yeah, but I'm saying it's not the same as a dude sitting on the couch and a woman just taking care of it. That's not the same.
That is the same.
I mean, because it's some men that do get stuff from women, right?
Oh,
because
he cut the grass and stuff?
No, they be trying to make things happen.
With her lawnmower?
Meaning they be trying to flip or make things happen.
Flip.
Yeah, get some money. They be trying to make things happen.
You want not do that. And keep doing it. Just close it. Fuck it. Because it just keep on doing it. Punishment. Laptop punishment.
Hey, it's doing it.
Yeah, but it happened though, Tay.
It do. It do happen. It happens like that. But I'm speaking to the point of women not having that privy. Like, that happens on a regular basis. And I don't want to say it's a Milwaukee thing, but it does happen here a lot, where you find women in households where they faking like they men really fucking with them the long way, and it ain't even that. And you don't know until some real shit happened, and then he ain't got her back. Because I ain't gonna lie, even for your friends or family, when you got those women that have men in their house, you have expectations there. When you asking me to borrow some money and stuff like that, I don't have no friends like that, but I hear about things like that on a regular basis, I'm going to look at you different.
But why, though?
Because your man there, and y'all supposed to be equal.
No, but I'm saying, why do the woman put up with that, though?
Why do they put up with that?
That's a good question.
Why do they tolerate that? Like, I'm going to tell you what it is, though. I'm going to be real. I'm going to tell you what it is. It be the dick. That's what it be.
I don't even think
it do. Yeah. Because if you got good dick, it'll keep you around longer than it would if you ain't got nothing else going on.
Oh, yeah, y'all know. Yeah, good
stock.
Good dick prolong a lot of bad relationships.
Exactly.
I think it's a lot of woman don't want to be alone.
No.
I think it's a lot of niggas that if they wasn't fucking good,
they would have been gone years ago.
I don't think it's sex. I think it's loneliness. The way it is now for me, hearing people speak, like even talking to your friends, you know, right. Girl, why you keep dealing with that? You know, you better than that. It's loneliness. They don't, and you want a companion.
It's a combination
it's
of both.
It's a small percentage.
Of sex and
being lonely,
or is it that you having sex because you don't want to be lonely?
That too, because you got to think about, for a lot of women, a woman can't just walk away quick like a man could and be sleeping with somebody 2 weeks later.
Lori Harvey does it.
Yeah. And Shamika, you know how you.
I don't know nothing.
You said, give me the game. Go show me the game.
LHJR. That's Lori Harvey Jr. right there. Player.
Tina, I agree with you. Lusting.
You
said right. Lusting.
Well, you know, sometimes a person
from a spiritual aspect.
Same way, if a person in a relationship, you might have a love, you love somebody, but you got a lust for somebody else. But the lust ain't never gonna go nowhere. Right. That's just something that you look at. You see a woman in a bikini or whatever, you look, but yeah, I don't wanna go home with her. I just look.
And sometimes you feeling like you love them, and then when you leave them alone, they might ask you for $40.
Here
like,
you go. What niggas is you dealing with that's asking for 40, man? What niggas is asking for 40?
I don't want them to keep it.
The niggas I know, they might.
I'm bad in general.
Mika, the niggas I know might ask you for $40,000. No, you ain't going to ask them for
$40. $40,000?
Like, yeah. You for $40,000.
401k out.
If you ask me for $40,000.
You already know. You ask some shit like that.
You ask me for $40,000, you gonna get the same reply.
Hey, listen, it's a nigga in this room right now. I got 20 out of motherfucker.
That shit was easy, but the thing about it is, I didn't run off. I turned that 20 into 40.
Yeah,
and I made her better.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Because I already had 20 at the gate. So I had 40 to go in when I was trying to do.
Because there's some niggas that's trying to get that money, but they ain't trying to use you. They still trying to make sure you're straight.
If you invest in, that's something different.
But why were y'all together?
Wait. No, we weren't together. We just had an understanding.
Well, can I go ahead.
So it's that good.
I'm just saying, man. You know,
look at me.
Hey, I'm just. Hey, listen. I'm just speaking facts, though.
Get a piece.
Look at me.
I mean, when you got a mouthpiece, and you got that, you know what I'm saying? I'm talking about both mouthpieces. I mean, it's gonna get you in the dough,
both
pretty much.
Mouthpiece.
Throat baby. That nigga said throat baby.
Because I do a lot more listening than any damn thing, okay. Analyzing. So I can see. I got to know my personnel.
Okay. My bad, y'all. I just had to bring out a real situation real quick. My bad. Back to topic. Everybody scratching their head in here.
I don't know what to say to that.
I know what to say, but I'm waiting till the comments is off to say what I got to say.
Shit, you ain't got no G's. Hey,
20 G's.
That's why I be hearing about, I'm hearing about this $400 shit. Like, what that shit gonna do?
We
gonna
go get like a whole lot of people, but never like them enough to give them my bread.
Listen, yeah. Mika, listen.
I'm saying this live.
I've never had that kind of bread that made me want to give up some women that are clean, it's some women that are clean, they 401k.
Yes,
because they lonely, insecure, all of those things.
But no, it's just that a nigga might say the right.
It ain't got no friends.
A nigga might say the right dream and say, "Listen, I'm gonna do this."
And sell the right dream. You hurt yourself.
No, but meaning that a nigga.
But you hurt yourself.
A nigga really do it though.
Sell the right dream.
He sell the dream, but then he make it happen.
So back to what I was saying.
John Ashley said, "What's the name of the drug?"
Okay.
I'm
trying to give a nigga some. What?
Hey, listen. This the thing though. You got a lot of women that'll give niggas money. They ain't got shit going on, and they never made nothing happen.
Man,
go get him the whole goddamn 20.
Now, see, that's the problem right there.
No, he'll fuck off artists.
That's true. That's the problem. You said it's the difference between a nigga and your man, your nigga, the person that you deal with. Like, a lot of times, they don't even be in committed relationships with these people. They be dropping these bands off to.
Because, listen, I know a chick, right? She told me, why would I, like, basically, like, saying, like, okay, let's just say, you say, listen, you take 10, 20 bands of your money, I'm going to take 10, 20 of mine and make something happen. She said, why would I help a nigga that already doing good? I said, why would you help a nigga that's not doing good? That don't make sense.
But for me, that ain't help, though. You ain't helping me because I'm already cool. I'm trying to show you something different and enhance your mind into something better. You know what I mean? Like, don't come around me always complaining about or saying things like, oh, it must be nice when you see me pull up in something or you see me doing something. Because I ain't trying to even jack it down on you because I'm not no jacking it down type of nigga. I'm just, at the end of the day, it just shit happens. And when you come around me saying, oh, wow, it must be nice. My thing is this. Like, okay, I can show you how to do it. I can show you how to get out of that $10 to $15 hour job if you want to sit down and listen. But if you can't bring nothing to the table, you know what I'm saying? You got to bring something. I'm not asking for you to do anything for me because I'm cool. And I'm not trying to make it seem like I'm just up top. But I'm around there, though. But what I'm saying is stop complaining and start taking some risks and taking some chances.
Thank you for allowing us to be in your presence this evening.
This girl be climbing.
Hey, I'm listening.
John
Ashton said, I haven't met one person to go into my 401k.
Atina said
said she has done that before.
Done what?
Invested. I think she's trying to say.
Yeah. Well, that's what. Let me go back. I don't mean help. I mean invest. Meaning that if you taking your bands and he putting his bands, y'all investing in something. But it's some women that feel like if you already got bands, why would I do anything with you? I would rather give my bands to a person that has nothing and he get it from the ground. Which that has happened also. Which it is some women that gave a nigga some money with no money and he made some shit happen and took care of them. But it's rare, but it have happened.
But bro, how top am I, bro?
Okay,
I'm the type of person, I'll do some paperwork with her to let her know that I'm official. I ain't trying to run off with your little money. Because I'm the type of person, I'll make that money and give it all to you and keep it moving.
I think it's the delivery for me. Like, you might be all of that. You know what I mean? I'm not taking that away from you. You may be all of that. But we're saying, if I'm not with you, I don't know how much I feel interested in investing in you, is what we're saying.
It's not about investing in me, but it's investing in us. Because
I'm asking you, are we together?
We don't have to be together. We can have an understanding, and we can have some paperwork solidified like real business people do it. I don't want no title, because a title don't define shit.
I think with that too,
but you gotta come like that too, like a business partner.
It depends on your character alone. Because, for instance, I was just dealing with somebody that came off to be that type of person. You know what I'm saying? But when you really got to see the way that they move in life, if I see the way you moving out here in these streets, I'm really not doing no business with you. Just the way you move with me alone.
Exactly.
Outside of business, I would never do business with you. If I'm learning how conniving you is, how sneaky you is, outside of, you know, just dealing with you, I definitely wouldn't do business. But I have had some relationships like that where I could bust a move with people like that because they have that type of credibility with me.
But Mika, I'm just saying, though, it's just an opportunity that I'm throwing out there because I hear the complaining all the time about right. It's never enough. So it's like, if you know you got something sitting around, I'm not saying that give it to me and trust and believe in me. If you, you know, I want you to treat it as a business relationship. Mm-hmm. Like, let's have some paperwork.
Are we fucking?
We could be fucking.
Nah, see,
listen, thing though. Hold on. Let me say this. This is the thing though. It don't make me no difference. It don't make me no difference.
Now I want to fuck. Let me
say this though. It don't make me no difference if we fucking or not. That's just something. That's an option too. Just like this shit is.
That shit ain't no option. Because guess what? Once we start fucking, we go together. And once I start spending money,
once I start spending. Well, that's most women.
Yeah, but they need to say that.
You better say that to me. Don't just assume a goddamn thing.
Women don't say that. These days they allow all those things you talking about to play out, and they be like, oh, I thought that we was, and then when you out kicking it with the next bitch because you start feeling her, but you told the first bitch that y'all ain't had nothing going on, but you kicking it with the next bitch and she doing investments too, and then she looking at that bitch crazy and she got problems with that bitch.
I can't speak for other guys, but I'm gonna speak for me. I done already had an understanding with you before I even start doing something with you, so you know what it is from Jump Street or whatever. So if you decide to go along or whatever, it is about what I said. I'm keeping it real. That's just what you want.
What you said. I'm talking about women out here, what they're doing. So they get with these men, they do investments. He must like me. He want to invest in me. He wants us to do more.
Invest in me.
Yeah, you said we're gonna do an investment together. We're doing better moves for each other together.
Just say the word again.
Together. Invest together.
Together.
Yes. What part of
stop saying me then?
What do you mean?
You're referring like I'm investing in her.
I said what a woman is thinking mentally. He wants to see me progress in life for us, because he said together. He wants to see me progress as well as him. And now we're moving around. We're moving along together. So she ain't got no choice but to feel like that. Y'all do all these relationship things, but oh no, I told you this. That's not fair.
Okay, listen. I'm just saying this though. If we cool, or we doing whatever we doing, at the end of the day, I'm going to have an understanding with you. Now, here's the thing. I'm doing this out the kindness of my heart, because apparently...
Kindness of your heart.
Meaning, like, the opportunity that I'm bringing to the table.
Message. But how did you come? How did you come with this, though?
Well, I sat there and listened at all this shit she started complaining about.
How did you come? We're going to start from the beginning. Okay, how did you come to that woman? How did you come to that woman? Because I think everybody needs to have real conversations.
What a suggestion.
Wait, I think everybody needs to have everybody. That's Dante talking about some ain't fuck. You know you ain't fucking me without the real going. Let me know what's happening. Ooh. That ain't happening.
Oh, here we go.
No, it's all good.
Man, don't be jumping on Dante like that, man. Hold on. We ain't having that.
He's speaking in general. He's talking about the guy ain't fucked. He just said, period. He ain't talking about
nobody. Okay,
no, this the homie. He cool.
Okay, don't jump on Dante.
But I'm talking about you meeting a woman. How did you come? So most men believe that they need to come with these false, we going to be together, or I should look out for you. Let's talk about this. Because you ain't just jumped out like... All y'all
come like that.
I don't jack it down.
Yeah, but I think a lot of women, because I watch it from a lot of women. I've never been in a predicament because I never gave my money to anybody. Right. But I think a lot of times women feel like even if you saying you won't want them, once I drop this money to him, it's going to change his mind. And you still end up with that same type of woman. Like,
it ain't that I don't want you. It's just that I'm trying to get to know you, and I'm just trying to see, can I build something with you in a sense? I'm just trying to have an understanding.
See if you can build something to do what? What's next?
I want to, this is the thing, though. I can't have a woman that ain't got the kind of same type of mind frame.
So she does, not what?
You said what?
She does. She's listening. She hears everything you're saying, and it sounds like a great move. What's next?
If she want to get in tune, then we going to be cool.
In tune. That's deep. In tune. Then what?
What you mean, then what?
Then what? She invested in you. She sent you the money. What's happening?
I'm going to make it happen. That's easy.
Make it happen. What's going on with y'all status, though?
We working on that.
Oh. See? You couldn't even say that with a straight face.
Yes.
I'm just saying, though.
I hear bro, you got quiet, think, though. You've been loud the whole time.
How you
time.
Feel about it, bro?
You got shot
Ms.
in.
Russell said, I'm Ray Charles when we talking about my coins.
That's
why you my mama. Because I be like,
Miss Nika.
Throw some water in your eyes.
I don't care how much I like him. He might start talking about money. And I'm
all
like,
I'm saying is this.
I feel good. Finding reasons like, I don't know.
All I'm
like
saying
is this. But see, this is the thing, though.
I'm
going to head out.
See, you can't really. Hey, listen, if a nigga is talking about y'all investing together, that's not a. Like, some women look at some niggas as opportunists. if you talking about y'all investing together, then that's talking about business.
It's almost tax time. I need the ladies to understand what's going on.
But you know what, though, Tay? I do think you can't mix business with pleasure.
For sure. Tell them.
So meaning that you can do business with a woman, but once y'all start fucking, the business she lose track.
See, depending on where her mind frame at.
Huh? Tell them.
No.
I'm not forcing nobody to do anything. I'm just opportunity I'm throwing on the table is for you.
Because numbers don't lie. I don't care if we smashed or not. Numbers don't lie. So if it's working, right. Hey, you go your way, I go mine. But just as long as
everybody, all the women don't have a heart like that.
I find it. Let me say this though. I find it amazing how women give a nigga like me. That's like trying to help them on another tip and trying to bring them in on something. They want to give me a hard time. But the bum ass nigga that was just laying up in this motherfucker for 3 years ain't doing shit.
But he did.
He was eating for free. He was driving your car, tearing the motherfucker
up. So what?
Up.
He went and put gas in it.
Okay, he put... What? That's petty shit again, though.
That's petty to you. It's life to them.
No, it ain't... No, that's petty. Because at the end of the day, I'm a man. If I'm with you, I'm going to pump the gas. I'm going to pay for the gas.
Period. You know, talked about this before, just on some... When we was all hanging out.
No, right.
A lot of women don't go on dates. They don't even require a date these days. That's not even a requirement in life anymore.
Well, I don't know what type of women them is sometimes. You know, I mean,
there's the women in Milwaukee. Period.
And a lot of women, you make it clear you want a date, and they still be like, "We hanging out at my house like
or
that."
Can I come to your house?
Well,
your
that goes to a certain women. House. It's certain women that's gonna set a standard where they're gonna let you know ain't no house. So it's either date.
Ain't
nothing.
No house. My
so it's
my date house cluttered with
so
like,
here's the thing though. Exactly. Here's the thing though. Like at the end of the day, what women don't understand is if a nigga got in his mind that he just wanna fuck. See, it's a lot of niggas that wanna fuck on you but not fuck with you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true.
So at the end of the day, a nigga will take 1,000 dates. And once he get to the ass, if that's what he on, he gone. So it don't matter about if you give it to a nigga today.
Huh? He should have just paid for it, because if you don't go on 1,000 dates with somebody, just offer
a question,
little something more than $40. They done manipulated women into thinking that 40 is what you're supposed to
charge. I don't know where you're talking about 40.
I think they should go higher because
of 40 is, yeah. Niggas pay more for niggas. Roses cost more than that. Hey. I don't know where niggas.
See, you light skin.
I spent $40 on
these light skin niggas ain't buying no roses.
Oh, no. Niggas buy, everybody buy roses.
I'm just playing.
Say, I got a question.
What's that?
What does the 40,000 damn dates, what does that solidify in the situation?
Getting to know me initially.
I got to go on 40,000 dates to get to know you?
I didn't say 40,000, but maybe
30,000. You just said 40,000. Did she say 40,000?
I didn't say 40,000. Yeah. I said, I think that dates are needed. They're necessary. Yeah. When you first meet someone, I think a lot of things go left the moment that you decide, oh, we can come to your house or we can come to my house. Because now you done came in my personal zone.
Space. Yeah.
And now everything is whatever you want to do at that point. I just don't think that a lot of women... take it easy. Slow down. It's okay to be a lady. You don't have to be at my house for me to get to know you, because am I really going to get to know you the right way?
I would have just taken you to the park and go get some ice cream.
That's cool, too. That's a date.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a date. Yeah.
Not to a lot of women. Yeah. They feel like you got to take me somewhere.
But those are the women that probably ain't been nowhere.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, exactly. Yeah. That's
but
why
that's a date. If you want to go for a walk,
man,
that's
any,
cool,
listen,
too.
Anywhere out the house, anywhere out the house, anywhere out the house is considered a date, man. If y'all go to the movies, it's a date. If y'all go walk in the park, that's a date. If y'all go goddamn look at the lake, go down to the lake and just watch the ducks and shit, that's a date.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, spending time in general to me.
Yeah.
It's a date.
Yeah,
it's a date. We talked about before too, where couples don't date as much either. So when you get with somebody, you still need to do dates. Whether y'all planning to watch a movie together, those are dates. Mm-hmm. Or I'm cooking your favorite meal and we doing a one-on-one, that's a date.
Yeah.
But the once we get together, we can do that house thing. But I think people don't take the time to communicate with one another and get to know each other.
Mika, what's a date for you?
Me and my sister is just like, hand in hand.
Who?
It depends on, too. And I know the first date, I'm going to know the first date, whether we going out to eat, whether we going to the park, or we going to the lake. I know right away just from having a conversation with him if I like him or not. So I'm not even going to go on another date. I ain't going to even prolong this thing. Nah. If I don't like you, I don't like you.
What about you, Tia?
Yeah, I feel that.
Well, I feel like with me, you're not coming to my house, first of all. But
okay, that's cool.
Like, I'll say I'll be trying to see what a man mind is at, and I'll be like, okay, where would you like to take me? You know what I'm saying? So
let him lead. I like that.
Yes. Because it had been times, and women love that. You might not know that, but women love for a man
But here's the thing, Mika.
It had been a man that had asked me to come to my house, and right away I know I don't like
Okay, now tell me this. Now, bro, Mike can speak. He might can understand what I'm saying. You know how you tell a woman, hey, let's go on a date, right? Mm-hmm. And then you say where you want to go. She say, it don't matter. You know, I ain't picky. It don't matter. You say, hey, let's go to this little spot in Mequon. No, I don't want to go there. Well, let's go to Red Lobster. No, I don't eat that. Let's go to Olive. No, I don't eat that. Let's go to Carson's. No, I really don't want to go over there. So you say, damn, where you want to go then? At the end of the day, you telling me it don't matter, but every place I say, you say no.
Well, I can't speak to that.
So tell me where you want to go then. Because, you know, in reality, a nigga really don't give a fuck where you want to go. Let's go. But so make the decision. So how can I leave if you showing me the way?
Even me being her friend, her best friend, her whole, I don't eat this, I don't eat that. That shit, hey, so fucking annoying. Like, you know what I mean?
She's gotten better.
Okay, that's cool to you. So better. you shouldn't let a man say he gonna tell you, gonna take you on a date. You tell him if you tell you a date, you say, well, I really love such and such, and he said, let's go there.
I do that.
Yeah.
So here's the thing, though.
But I do like for them to take the lead.
I want to talk about dates too, because dates can be tricky when you pick where you want to go.
I'm gonna tell you how a guy can make it so much easier. That first conversation, getting to know her, getting to know the things that she like, the things she don't like. Is she a fucking vegetarian? Whatever the situation is, because that can kind of
barley.
Exactly, because that could kind of dictate like where you want to take her and where you feel like.
Wait, you said what? I'm sorry, I missed the first part.
What part did you miss?
You said what dictates where you want to take her.
Okay, so basically what I'm saying is when you get to know somebody, right? You get to know the things that they like and they don't like. You make it so much easier for yourself as a man to know where the best place to take
her. Yeah, communication coming.
That's the communication. That's having phone conversations for a week or two.
But,
and then y'all decide y'all want to go out. And this could all be a fairy tale in my head, but that's how I like it to go.
Right, but also if you're a generous woman, you find out the small things that moves him besides sex.
For sure.
Because we know we could take that any day. You know what I'm saying?
Fuck your mind, for sure.
Exactly. Find out the small things that he like or whatever, and know and you can know how to move with him. You'll know how to move with him.
Add you on this video to do what, girl?
Like Nikki Russell said, I'm cool with Starbucks.
Yeah, I mean, don't explain.
That's her easy. Bougie. Starbucks. I love Starbucks. Starbucks Valley.
Yeah, I don't think it's anything.
Knowing her bougie self.
I need a caramel Starbucks Valley.
You know what I'm saying?
No, and I'm glad you just said that, bougie. So when a lot of women think like, I want to go to Benihana's. Benihana's cheap as hell.
Yeah,
like,
that ain't bougie
like,
no more.
That shit really cheap. Like, it's a lot of places that's really fucking cheap.
Carson's ain't even really up top like that no more. It used to be.
You think it's cheap? Can you take me?
Yeah, lunch. Yeah.
That's fine.
Yeah.
Can I get an appetizer?
Look. Yeah.
I told you I love the Mediterranean shrimp. Can I get an appetizer?
Yeah. Carson's, yeah. We're going to go.
This
yeah.
is great. It's only six shrimp.
If they need some ideas, I give them some.
So you're
going to
need two orders? It's
six shrimp.
If they need some date ideas, I got some.
Look at your face.
We're going to need y'all to stop going to Carson's and Benihana's and Red
Lobster. We going to Wendy's.
Oh, you taking me to Capital Grill first day, baby.
Capital Grill.
I like how Tay slid that in, though. Y'all see her, right? Y'all peep that, right?
Yeah.
I'll do what I can.
Sound like she got more game than Shakespeare.
I'm a lover.
She a lover.
Ain't nothing wrong with Carson, man.
I'm a one man at a time type of chick.
Y'all better watch. We're
going to take a limo
but
there.
But the problem
Ooh,
is...
limo.
The problem is...
Limo.
We doing a big...
Hey, the old Cadillac one. We're going to take the old Cadillac one.
Extra long one.
The granddaddy one.
No, the mini one. The mini one my granddaddy used to have back in the day.
The short booty one.
Open the other way?
Yeah, with $1 million in the trunk.
I'm going to do just like this. I'm going to let you know right from my window. I don't feel good.
Hey, I'm going to like, shit, we can get your shit to go. How much is the six-piece shrimp?
No, six-piece. He don't even sound right saying it.
What you say? Six-piece, right?
That's such an insult. Six-piece.
What you say? Then you say six-piece shrimp?
Yeah, you don't say that, though, to the people.
What you say?
You ain't going to order it like that, is you?
I'm gonna say Mediterranean six.
Mediterranean,
piece, Mediterranean, whatever.
Don't be saying no six.
So wait a minute. Let me read some of these comments, y'all.
Read them.
Shout out to Polly. Hi, Polly. Y'all say hi, Polly.
Polly, what it
Polly, do? Polly, what it is?
John Ashley said, I do judge if someone wants to take me to certain places.
And I
we're not going to even get on Rich Kelly.
But I was going to say why that happens like that. So sometimes you get women, right? Sometimes you get women that want to go to these expensive places, but they don't even dress the part. Okay? So having on a whole bunch of like color bangles and all that shit, and you be like, you want to go somewhere where it's like real, like the lights dim. Right. You know, that's not
with
cute.
A tracksuit.
That's not cute. I mean, I don't have no Gucci, nothing, y'all. I don't have none of that kind of stuff. And I'm not saying I'm the fashionista of the world. I'm not saying that. But I'm saying a lot of bad bitches think they bad because they can buy these different bags and all that. But when it's time to get dressed and go have a real date,
they can't even pronounce the shit that's in there.
They can't pronounce it. I don't want to talk about
what is this?
But,
what is this?
But
the California state.
But no, for real, they don't look the part. Like they don't know what to put on. Like you want to go to Capitol Grill, yeah, but you come out in a whole Nike jogging suit.
You know what? You know what, Tay? I understand why when women go on dates, right? And y'all ask where we going because y'all need to know what to dress. Because niggas be trying to surprise, but you don't want to mess around and be overdressed and get there and say, nigga, this Olive Garden was a surprise. Like, nigga, why could have worn? I could have worn jogging suit.
No, if my man want to take me to Olive Garden, but he gonna set it up. That wine, some of that wine is expensive, and he gonna set it up. He probably got us a nice little table or something. That's cool. I'm so cool with that. And he want me to dress a certain way. I'm totally okay with that. But I'm talking about those women that give y'all the go to what? Because they been there with some D boys. I didn't jump out on a date like really met a nigga at this is when Cheesecake Factory first opened. This nigga had on all the fucking graffiti stuff on his shirt. Like, he had bullshit on his pants was, like, blingy, like. And I got the fuck up out of there. Swear to God. I was like, I had my homegirl call me, like, shit, say it's an emergency.
Wow.
Bayshore, I slid the fuck up. With Bayshore Cheesecake, I slid the fuck up.
He had the graffiti on.
Wow.
I don't do all that stupid junk shirt shit. Like, that's you too old. He was too old. Like, I'm out of here. I don't want to be seen like this. This is embarrassing. Or, like, even at my age now, don't come pick me up in no fucking big-ass rims and all that country-ass shit. I'm not finna be climbing in nobody's car in the car off flipping. I don't want to do that.
Hey, the Crown Vic on the Crown Vic on the 30s.
Like, banging, paint flipping. Like, I'm not interested.
And
like,
as we said before, I think the problem is a lot of people then let society determine how a first date is supposed to be, and they have not established that for themselves. Like,
facts.
When you comfortable with yourself,
right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go wherever I want to go.
But you know, really,
not
really,
because my friends doing
hey, here's
this.
Here's the thing.
Or,
here's the thing. Really, big thing. But you know what though? Really, niggas be liking a woman that's versatile, right? So yeah. You look at it like, damn, okay, baby, I took you here on the first date. Why so much pressure? You acting like this the last date. We're going to have 1,000 dates. Capitol Grill and Carson's coming. Just calm down.
It depends on what type of nigga it is, too.
Yeah, if you came out when I first met you and you all like, yeah, we in VIP, woo-woo. You ain't finna take me no motherfucking Chili's. Yeah. We ain't about to do that. TGIF Fridays, no, nigga. I want that money that you showed me. I don't need that.
Yeah.
No, and when the waiter comes because
they didn't give you the wrong impression out the gate. So now they got to live up to that. Now that's just like saying if you get a nigga and he's every week he sending you flowers and constantly you need lunch. Once that shit die down, she gonna say, nigga, what happened?
Right. I'm still eating.
So you gotta keep up with that. That's the problem. You gotta make sure whatever you started doing, you gotta keep up with that.
Do it. That's true.
Hey, so he say, Floyd J-Track say, so y'all don't like big rims no more. That's crazy.
Right.
We 30 and older. I don't know. Shit, hey, you gotta figure it out.
This is the thing. You do whatever you do, you know what I'm saying? But you gotta understand, though. That shit only going to draw that type of attention.
Yeah.
If you want a real woman,
don't hand me the pack. You can't be doing that. Don't hand me the pack.
So we can't do that no more, bro.
But you hand me the money because I can't wear this money.
Now here's the thing though. You got some niggas that'll meet a chick in a nice car, and then when they go pick her up, they might be in a trapper. Now is you going to get in that trapper, or is it going to be a problem?
Right. Is you going to get in there, Tay?
Wait, what happened?
Meaning that you might meet a guy, right? He might have a nice car when you met him, right? And when he come pick you up to go on a date, it might be snow on the ground. Goddamn, he gonna pick you up in the trapper. Is you still going?
I don't think he's gonna do that to me.
Right. Well,
why?
I had to humble somebody the other day and remind him, like, don't be up top. Because remember, I was messing with you when you had to wait for a ride to come pick you up. Right. You know what I'm saying? Right. So... a lot of these men, they humble always.
You couldn't get to where you was going. Right. You couldn't get to where you was going.
Tone, you hear this shit, man. Tone, you hear this shit.
But Look, you gotta stay humble.
Once you get in that lane, you gotta stay in that lane.
Yeah. Because there's some people, like, I really liked him when he was broke. Like, he was really my friend when he was broke, when he didn't have nothing.
He was genuine.
And we had a genuine relationship. Right. Now that he got a little something, because I ain't gonna say he really got something, but his whole attitude too didn't change. His whole attitude
didn't change. Mika, you gonna have a nigga come in here. What you gonna say?
I'm saying humble yourself.
Not a little something, probably just looking like you got something. Yeah, a lot of people make it look good. That be the whole thing to me.
Yeah.
Cause this bitch,
oh yeah, looks can be deceiving.
It's bitches with bags, and I'm talking about, girl, you think you can borrow me up? Like, hold on, no. You got that bag. I'm being judgmental as fuck. You got that bag? No, I can't do that.
I agree with y'all. I agree with y'all on that. I don't like that either.
Or every time you talking, they down it with you. Oh no, but I got this.
Let me read this. Oh, I got
that. But it's just,
Dante comment. He says, so can a first date be at one of our house if someone decides to cook?
I told you no.
hey, Tay, the thing is, Dante, I'm talking to Dante. Dante, the thing is that if you do that, it's always going to be the woman idea. The nigga can't never come up with no idea and say, come by the house, I'm going to cook for you.
Yeah.
Now, if the woman say, I'm going to cook for you, come by the house, or everything peachy.
Hey bro, listen. Look, hold on. I'm gonna step outside the box for a second. Now let's say we got the penthouse or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And she we got the penthouse. We
rooftop, you know what I'm saying? Tri level, you know what I mean?
And you know, and I'm gonna tell you, that woman know that dude up top or whatever. So she might be willing to let that ride because she figuring like he up top as it is, so why not? You know what I'm saying? That ain't nothing but let an average Joe or nigga that just hustling talking about some come by the crib.
This ain't no ordinary scenery, is what you're saying. Like, shit, exactly. I got some shit for you to see.
Well, you know what, bro? I disagree on that. I feel like it depends.
Waste your money, buddy.
I feel like it depends on the woman.
Dude, I was going to fuck anyways.
It depends on the woman because some women don't give a fuck how much money you got. You ain't coming to the house.
That's true.
Yeah. So it depends on the woman. It depends on that woman. Now, it's some women that just thirsty for some money and might be like, he got some bread. I'm going to let him come out of the house. You know what I'm saying? Maybe he might get my body done or something. You know, I don't know.
Get my body done.
Oh, that's another topic. Hey, that's another topic. Listen. Yes. That's another topic, right? My brother told me, he said, listen, now if you meet a woman, her body bad, it don't matter. You just get her body done.
I ain't getting no goddamn body.
I'm not getting my body done.
I'm from the South. I want the original shit.
Well, this, I'm not saying me. I'm just saying my big brother
right now. That's it.
My big brother, he told me, he said, that's the new wave right now. He said, if you meet a woman and she got the right hustle, her mind.
If I meet a nigga and he want me to go up under the knife, then that's another.
I agree with you, Mika. I don't want nothing fake. I want it all real.
Let me do it if I want to do it. Let it be my idea. Like, if we in a relationship. But not just, you want to get your booty done, or you need to have a smaller waist or something like that. I don't know what type of dude you is. I'm not. He's trying to say his brother. He's saying, oh, my body, I don't like this, and that's a slip. This is how my brother feel.
But at the end of the day, I'm not against nobody. If somebody feel they need to get something done, I'm not against it. I'm, you know, if I fuck with you and you trying to do something, I'm 100%. I'm
but
all
with
for
the
it.
with the
well,
trap.
I got these 20 G's and I need five of them.
Man, shit. I don't listen. I like you for who you is. If I'm messing with you, no matter what the situation is, you don't need to go get nobody
well,
done.
Well, for me,
take pride, take self pride in yourself.
It's confidence at the end. Yeah,
exactly.
That,
yeah. especially if you fucking with a boss type nigga and he telling you, yeah, baby, you valid. You know what I'm saying? You cool or whatever. That's enough solidification in itself.
Yeah. I mean, because not only that though, you might meet a woman and she might be good, and then later on down the line she slip up. That's cool. If I fuck with you, I'm with you.
Hey, exactly. Real, Elba said this. Men forget that women gotta like you. All that extra stuff don't mean shit. So that's true. That means nothing.
That's why I said, waste your money, buddy. Because she already know in her mind if that's what you on. A woman really got to be on that. I don't care how much money you got, Ashley, or what you have. She'd already had her mind up if she was gonna smash you as soon as she got there.
Look at niggas and be like, I'm finna fuck, though. No. I be trying
it's
to see what you
out
know.
Here like that though.
No, I be when I look at a nigga, I be. Nah, I ain't gonna even say what I be.
What you be looking
right.
at?
Right. Your hurt is worse than sex. You be looking right. like.
When you be at Lux. Like when you be at Lux. When you be at Lux. What do you look at them niggas and say?
I
when I be at Lux. Lux, I don't be at Lux all the time.
Or Diamond.
But that, those are my people, and I don't look at nobody in the bar. When I go out, I really be going out with my people. I really don't be looking at no niggas, for real. I don't be like, oh, girl, he look good. I don't think I've ever done. Y'all remember me doing that? I've never done that. When I go out, I really go out to be out and have a good time.
She did it that one time, y'all. I'm just playing.
When?
I'm like,
we just talking shit, man.
No, I really don't. Because I think that sometimes when you out, especially at night, I'm cool as hell. You know, my name Ashley. When I'm out, I'm a great time.
And you the just next day, Ashley.
No, they know now I posted it.
That's been her name for years.
My name has been Ashley for years, but that lets me know how I'm going to answer my phone. You know?
So when it would be Tay?
If she when it's you. Real.
Look, when she likes
when it's real. I don't, when it's Ashley, I know that I can exit this conversation.
Nigga, y'all know what her, nigga, y'all know what her name used to be, though, nigga. Here.
No. Da, 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 da.
Anyway. You see, when Nikki said, she said, say it. Your mental first.
For sure.
For say sure.
What her name used to be?
What her name used to be, bro? Tell me. I want to know.
Why y'all making this about me? The women scared to let you see them on the bad hair.
Fuck all that. Dante, tell me what the name is, bro. Fuck all that. What's
my
your name?
Dante is making this so personal. No,
it is self-esteem, too.
Get the strap.
Yeah, get the strap.
See, a lot of women, too, that get their body done, they figure, if I get my body done, I'm gonna attract these type of niggas. More niggas gonna want me, or more niggas gonna fuck with me.
But is it genuine? Is it genuine?
It's not genuine.
Right.
That's why you should see who it's not.
But see, that goes with it's a self esteem issue.
For sure.
You know, they lack confidence.
They walking around here with booties too big.
Don't match their thighs. Man.
But that is true though. What do you expect to get out of that when you change your look?
Your looks, right.
When you change your looks, what do you expect to get out?
You went and got that $20,000 body, right? And a nigga come at me, a fat girl, okay?
They love them. Get their body done.
Tia, listen, you not fat.
But okay, a thick chick, but...
You got your shit together, you fine as a motherfucker.
Oh, thank you. Mm. It's okay? That's what I like. Hey. But no, for real, though. A lot of women go out and get their body done.
Dante, you going to get blocked.
What'd he say?
He's talking about I got a dirty mouth to be so classy.
Everybody keep asking
let me
where
talk
I
my shit.
Everybody keep asking where I live at. They can't find it.
It's in the group.
It's in the group.
Yeah, I just tagged my
they got to be in the group.
I just tagged my sister. Be in the group.
Tell them first thing first. Support.
Or they got to be on Tom Delph Lucky page.
No, they need to be on our Ruffled Feathers page.
Rich Kelly said they trying to catch a thirsty trick.
I don't
trick.
Even see it on the Ruffled Feathers.
Who trying to catch a thirsty
what,
trick?
What, the live? The live not on there?
It is.
That's how they got on.
Okay, y'all, listen to this.
Yeah, I'm looking at it. I don't see
it. What if she's 40 and had her kids and wanted to tighten up? What's wrong with that?
Tighten up, like get her body done?
Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that.
Say that again.
Tighten up, like get her body done?
Yeah, get her body done.
What if she's 40
and she had her kids and want to tighten up?
Ain't nothing wrong with it. Ain't nothing wrong with it.
There's nothing wrong with getting your body done. Let's say that. But getting done for the right reasons.
Mm-hmm. Either yeah, way, ain't nothing right. wrong with it.
It's true.
Either way, ain't nothing wrong.
Just don't add shit. Don't be adding all that. Don't add nothing. You can get it lift up. You can get it tightened up. But don't add. Don't put no foreign objects in your body.
I guess that makes me think, but like, what are you doing
girl.
It for? Exactly.
Well,
well see,
foreign,
here's
girl,
the thing.
You need to put
here's,
it in your body.
Hey, here's the thing, though, Tay. A lot of women can't understand because they don't need their body done. So a lot of women that can't understand how they do that is because they don't need that shit.
But don't be who y'all be liking. I'd have been to somebody's house. She got her butt done. And she ain't even got a refrigerator installed. Like, what is your kid?
But a lot of niggas don't. Looking. But this is the thing, though, Mika. A lot of niggas don't be knowing if a woman got her body done or not. We don't be looking for that type of shit.
Y'all know.
Yes, y'all do. Y'all
we don't look for that type of shit.
Y'all notice that.
Boy, please.
Now, if you go back and look at some old pictures and then see some new ones, you might notice it. But you don't just go and say, damn, she was thin last week and now she thick this week. You don't,
I think, like, what's the rush? Like, everybody, there's lots of people that go exercise on a regular basis. Like, what's the big rush to have your body done? What's going to change? Like,
that's all I'm saying.
It's a mental thing. Like, if you still not confident in yourself, you're still going to have those issues, those insecurities. Like, I don't understand. I personally don't understand. It's not going to make niggas attract to you because they're going to still hear you. You know, hear how you think mentally, how you process things. You still, that just because you got a nice body don't mean you a bad bitch.
So, wait. Floyd said, hey, what if a man go get their body done?
Okay, that's just gay.
Yeah, I ain't going to get my body done.
Hey, some men do, though. They said Ray J got a fake penis.
He done did something to his penis.
I know a few people that need to get their body done. No, I'm just playing.
Hey, and some.
Wow. Yeah, I don't know.
So fake penises?
Yes, fake penises. Make it bigger and all that type
Somebody
of
said that, though?
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Stay strapped.
We safely men and their imperfections. Yeah, that's what we said at the beginning of this. We have to take them with their imperfections. Like, they can have their linings all fucked up, but I know they going to get their hair done now.
They be
having that hype. No, they do. They be getting that. They got the fake thing where it looks all real. Yeah, where you can put the little things on, the shavings. Yeah, it's super cool.
Ain't gonna be mad we both get home and take off.
Stupid,
no, no, but that is one of our questions today, right? So, makeup or not?
No.
Why?
Because I want to see the original.
Yeah, I like natural.
Okay, what about sometimes?
But here's the thing: ain't nothing wrong with makeup, but too much. Now, there's some women that put makeup on and make them look bad, worse. Like, meaning there's some women you see with makeup and you say, now when you can see where the line and shit start, you like, oh, hold on. But it's some women that put makeup on and make them look worse. And you're like, baby, you don't even need that. You don't need none of that. It make you look worse.
Well, what if it makes her feel beautiful and she ain't got her body done yet?
If it's my woman, then I'm a uplifter then.
See, that's some light-skinned nigga shit.
What you mean? How's that light-skinned shit take?
No, yeah. I'm saying good job.
Oh. I'm just saying I'm an uplifter if she
I didn't
wear
say
that.
Beam lines, but, Dante.
But I'm saying if I got a preference, I really, you know, I want you to be natural. But if that's what you want to do, what you want to do, I'd have supported. Because at the end of the day, some niggas don't understand that when you got a woman, you got to tell her, yeah, you look good, baby. You might not even looked at her.
Right.
Yeah, damn, baby, you looking good as hell today. You ain't even looked at her when she got in the car. You got to just, it's
that's
all
also some light-skinned nigga shit.
It's uplifting, though.
It's uplifting. You said, I ain't see you. Dude said, what part you like?
Because you know why? Because a woman to go to work and say, damn, he didn't even notice I put a little blind streak in my hair today.
We got two of them saying nothing wrong. Makeup is cool.
He said makeup is cool as long as it doesn't change your complexion. Yeah, a lot of bitches was walking around orange as hell.
Man,
a while ago.
It don't change my complexion, but it hide my mustache.
I just get mine waxed off. I just get mine waxed. Just get mine waxed.
Some makeup is like, I know a lot of women have like dark circles around their eyes. You put makeup on that. That's cool.
Yeah.
So don't be a whole Asian.
My thing
you know what though? I'm gonna tell you, like, Tone. Niggas don't like when a lot of women wear makeup and you got a white tee on. God damn it, you got all this shit all over your white tee. My shit white tee.
It's levels to makeup though. Don't they got the good one? Like, they got the good stuff that don't be doing that. Because if somebody did hug me before her whole face was on my shirt, I was pissed.
Right? Yeah.
Like, and she walked away like nothing happened. Right?
But it's some women that got a complexion where they just got that natural. They just got like a natural shine to them where they don't need that shit. You know what I'm saying? But like I said, if you feel like you need it. But when a woman got a man and he say, baby, you beautiful, you don't need it. She probably going to be like, I don't want that shit, man. If she got a nigga,
sometimes they
that.
Giving them 20 G's and they going to tell you, you beautiful.
Good. My nigga P.A.T., man, and got 20 bands
out
the mud,
it's,
man.
It's some chicks that's not the most beautiful that got some nice looking men. For real, it's some chicks that's big that got some. Like, I love big women,
you remember,
personally.
Hey, you remember?
I think big women have so much confidence, and it's so many smaller women feeling like, oh, because she big, that don't mean.
But remember, you remember, Tay? We had a conversation before. We said we don't mean to be acting funny, but it's more pretty heavy on chicks on the heavy end.
Yeah.
Then it is smaller chicks.
Yeah, that's why I'm gonna keep my fat.
And that's what I say about the body. They go get their body done. And a nigga want that big chick.
It's the confidence for me.
It's your confidence.
And she could. Let's be clear. It's some women that's on the heavy end that get more action than a woman that ain't.
Yeah.
Ain't gonna do it with money.
Ain't gonna do it with money. Sometimes it's just.
He said they big old freak. That's what making the stallion was talking about.
You right, John. Some of them got a goddamn throat like a damn tunnel.
Telling y'all live on podcast.
Right, my bitch. Some of them cute in the face.
And some of them got a throat like a tunnel. You right, Tom.
Oh, you know about everybody's throats.
Throat babies.
What about your throat?
What's your throat?
Huh? Oh, my. Hey. My shit. What it do, bro?
The roof.
This shit the roof. Look, yeah. Okay, let's be clear.
All right, what about weave or natural? Because first of all, let me talk about this natural life.
Say what? Weave or natural?
Weave or natural. Natural ain't the truth for everybody.
It's not.
Well, here's the thing.
Why I'm with this struggle going on a date.
I say both. Shut up. I say both.
Okay. Yeah.
There's nothing wrong
with
it.
Natural.
Mm-hmm. I like natural. I don't like all that other shit. Now, I used to didn't like weave, but, you know, as you get older, you just...
FYI, if we do this natural thing, you better accept me.
You're going to be looking like NDRE. I am not my hair.
Because when I go to bed, it might look like that. But when I wake up, it's not going to look like
Erica, Erica Bad, not Badu.
And that's the only style I know how to wear.
I have a little Philly fro.
So if we go to one.
Or had them braids like Cleo. Like them braids like Cleo had and set it off.
My buns work.
My buns be okay.
Yeah, they work. You
can. Yeah, we ain't never seen you in no damn bun.
You haven't.
We ain't never seen you in no bun.
You ain't never seen this because I don't never wear my hair.
When she on the 30, she had
that
on the 30.
Thank you. You gotta be gangster.
We got our
buns driving. What you wear when you be on the 72?
What's it?
72?
I don't
know.
Like
72.
The 27.
Look, the struggle that I did for it. The bun. Yes, the bun.
You got a little gangster, like, try me.
But tomorrow on that 30, I'm going to have this wrap. Maybe.
Y'all wear y'all scarf on the 30?
Yeah, I think I might. With my hat on.
Looking real ratchet.
Looking real ratchet. You got to fit in with them. You got to act
looking,
crazy.
Looking like them girls whose bodies y'all be getting done.
Bodies we be in too.
Yeah, how y'all make the decision who body y'all going to get done and who not?
Who y'all gonna pay for?
Who y'all gonna accept as they are?
I mean, if she wanna get her body done and nigga got the bread for it, he might pay for it.
What if you don't and she just saving up for it? You gonna talk her out of it?
Care. Credit. He might just pay the bill.
You love it.
He gonna pay.
Hey.
He might just pay the bill.
Hey, yo, mama said, wake up looking like buckwheat. And Floyd said, I'm going to be like, sir, why are you in my bed? Right.
Had that Philly thing in your head. Looking like Chrisette Michelle.
Floyd said, big girls are a preference for him. Now he's addicted.
Hey, ain't nothing wrong with that. Ain't nothing wrong with that. That's his preference, you know, but hey.
What's your preference?
You just got to be a big guy.
What's your preference?
Don't be walking around here talking about you want a big girl.
You know what? You want to know? See, I don't. Listen.
He ain't got one.
I don't want to say the wrong thing, but let me just say, you know, hey, you know, if you on my team, you know, you playing the right position.
Sure. Safe, yeah. So, Pat, what's yours?
You want to keep it real?
Mm-hmm.
My granddad told me if you can't pick him up and take him to the bedroom, you shouldn't be with him.
So that's how you pick him back?
Huh?
That's how you pick him?
I mean, that's what granddad said.
No, I'm asking how
that's
you pick
what
him.
Granddad said.
I mean.
Basically, that's.
Well, I ain't never had a big girl before. But I'm not saying. I don't know. I guess. Yeah. But I'm not discriminating or nothing, right. But I'm just saying, granddad, this is what granddad said, not me. This is what he said.
But
he told me, he said, grandson,
word,
if you can't pick her up and take her to the bedroom, you shouldn't be with her.
So what did you say?
I said, damn, granddad, I ain't never think of it that way.
So that's how you live now?
No, I'm just saying, like, you know, I don't want to, you know.
No, I want to know what?
Uh-oh. I'm open.
Open?
Yeah.
Okay, Pat.
I mean, I'm not really necessarily so picky, but then I'm finna sit here and tell a lie. But nah, I just like a woman that's nice looking.
I'm gonna keep it real for my nigga right here. He loved them petite motherfuckers.
I got my times where I like the petite ones, but I you know what I'm saying? I had my times where I was dating a lot of Latino women, but I just like a woman that's just for me. You know what I mean? When I lived in Rhode Island, I dated a lot of Dominican, Puerto Rican, and, you know, that Trinidadian type of women. You know what I'm saying? Not that I was knocking black women. That was just what was out there.
Did they understand what you were saying?
Yeah, because I know how to speak Spanish too. A little bit.
Say yes. Let's
go. Oh, my nigga, say man. Something.
Come on, senorita.
Look. Come on. Say something sexy.
Senorita.
Hey, I say something. I know something too. I know something too, y'all.
What you know?
Lizzie Cooper Thun.
That's saying something about coupons.
You know where I got that from? Home Alone.
I'm going to say a movie. He got that
I
from
thought he said coupons. Where are the coupons?
I said Lizzie Cooper Thun. I got that from Home Alone.
He know he gonna find you a good deal. I thought he said
but to really answer your question, I just like a woman that's nice looking with a great personality.
With a throw baby. Cook.
Yeah, that can cook. And that's just laid back and smooth at the same time.
So it's a lot of women nowadays that don't cook or clean up, so I hear.
I cook too, shit. I cook anything.
So would y'all be okay with that?
She gotta be willing to
or clean up. Like, well, where you get with her, she kind of tricked you a little bit, right? She was everything you thought. When y'all get together, is that a deal breaker where she don't cook or clean? She was just like keeping the house.
If she don't cook, a nigga respect a woman at least try. At least try to cook. And if you don't try to cook, then maybe whatever I want, you gonna find it and go get it.
I agree.
If I tell you something I want, you're going to go get it.
Depends I agree and I disagree.
What type of income you bringing in the house? You go get it. Like, what type
now, you know what? Now, I'm going to tell you, Mickey. I'm glad you said that, right? Because you know what a nigga hate? If you tell a woman you want something and she say, yeah, you just go get the food or whatever and I'll pay. I'll cook it. You go pay for it. And I'm like, damn. What am I fucking you for if I got to pay for the food for you to cook it?
What?
She might feel that way too. Like,
wait, what am I fucking you for if I gotta pay for it for you to cook it?
Meaning that if you tell a woman, hey, I got a taste for something, she say, yeah, just go buy all the stuff and then I'll cook it.
Do y'all live in the same house or?
I'm saying, like, if this is your woman, if this is my woman,
are y'all in the same house?
It don't matter. I'm saying, why do I have to go and buy the actual food for you to cook it? That don't make sense to me.
Why?
Huh? I'm gonna buy the food
And I'm gonna cook it.
Sound like even fair exchange ain't a robbery.
Yeah, your dick must not be that good.
Sound like another light skinned nigga moment.
Yeah.
Guess what?
That's that light skinned shit.
Because when that dick good, I'm gonna get up.
Now look, if I buy the food and you fuck it up, then we gonna have a problem.
If I buy the food,
God damn it. Because if you was gonna fuck it up and you knew you was gonna fuck it up, you should have just bought the shit yourself.
No, but it depends on what's going on.
It depends on what you want cooked too. I might have to go buy it. Do she have kids?
It could have been something like that.
Yeah. Make time for what you want to make time for.
What you mean? Dude said, put all the kids in the car. That's why you got to have a limit.
Got to ask you to buy it because my kids so trained, they're going to make sure you bring it something to the table. Like, what you buy? They're going to ask you. Like,
what you bring?
Yeah. Mika, you had me for a moment till you said that. Nah, I just
look. She went left. Then she was just doing good. She was all green. Man, you went red light.
I'm with moms though. She said just cash app her, and then she can go pick it up.
Well, let's be clear. I'm not gonna say I haven't sent no money to get no food made. I'm just saying that sometimes a nigga be like, damn, like it ain't like a nigga don't. I mean, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, I think so. That's a.
So I guess. So at the end of the day, I'm not saying that a woman always asking, but sometimes every now and then. But you never know. I guess you never know a situation. You never know what's really going on. So
yeah, but I think when you in tune with a person, then you kind of know their financial status and you know all that. I don't think nothing wrong with what you thinking the person should go get.
Yeah.
Oh, we got a question. Okay, first I want to say to Skylar said, if you request the food, you should buy it. And she cook it for you.
Mm.
Okay. Lloyd.
Is you going to clean up the kitchen, Ellie?
Right.
Is you going to clean up the kitchen?
Oh, I can. Ain't no problem.
I can. Look, you said, I'll do it. But... said,
then she going to bust it down for you later. Hey.
But here's the thing about a woman, though. A woman, when she cleaning the kitchen, you might ask her, hey, you need me. You know she ain't going to, she going to say no.
But you just
go and say, hey, you need me to help you? I got it.
Wait, we got a question, though.
Yeah, you know she's not going to let you.
You better grab the broom, because if I work today, you better get the broom in my pocket.
But here's the thing, though. A woman want a man at least offer it. Yeah. She's not going to let him because she wants
and
to control.
That woman
she wants to control the whole shit and make sure everything ain't going to be high her standard. So she might say, she's going to say no.
But DeAndre got a point. Yeah, if she's going to prepare the meal out of love, you should just buy it.
But let's be clear. I'm not saying I haven't. I'm just saying that. It's nothing wrong with it, but I'm just saying that it get to a point where you'd be like,
Like
Josh. Yeah, and I think it depends. If you're dealing with somebody, mind fill you on that. If you are dealing with somebody that likes to cook and you in tune with them, then they gonna get up and go get that shit. Like, true. And you ain't gonna tell me last like minute said, though. You know. You're not. Gonna
but you
tell
know
me
what though?
Minute,
how would it be right if a woman say, "Damn, baby, I like them steaks you be making or whatever. You should make some of them." And you say, "Yeah, cash out me the money. I'm gonna make them."
No, you can't do that.
I know you can't. You know why? Because you're gonna say, "Oh, this nigga, this bum ass nigga said cash out me the money for the steaks."
At least it's you know what's gonna be said. Don't ever do that.
Yeah, you already know how it go for men and women. It's different. Yeah, it's different. Yeah. It's a different story for both sides.
Like I said, like we was talking about back when we was talking about the school. When we said how a man can put a woman through school. How a man could put a woman through school and pay for everything, but when have you ever known a woman to say, "Yeah, I put my man through school, I paid for everything, and you know, I made sure he was good"? They gonna say she a stupid woman.
I did all
of
that.
But if a man do all that, they gonna say, "Oh, you know, he's a great man, he's a powerful man, you know, black power, all that shit." They gonna say all that.
Then you're going to say, "I did all of that," and then when he graduated, he got a new girlfriend.
Same way a woman graduated, and then all of a sudden you're talking to you slick, you ask her something, she frowning up now. You weren't frowning up when I was paying all these damn bills around here, before you was RN.
But you getting flued out next weekend, right?
Right.
Houston.
All right, so Derek's not going to be with us next week. So Pat not going to be here either. So it's gonna be.
I'm going live from the Turkey Hut.
It's gonna be ladies' night, but y'all, I definitely enjoyed tonight's show. Sorry that it started so late. We had some technical issues. We'll be on time next Saturday at 6:30 p.m.
Shout out to my boy Tone.
All right, so the guys gonna be here. We might have some fill-ins, some other guys. So we're gonna let some other guys come in and take y'all spot.
Maybe
it's tryouts.
Throw baby.
Alright. So y'all, so next weekend check in with us. It's no WAP, no service conversation.
20 G's.
Alright. So that's it for us tonight. That's it for y'all.
That's it. Y'all have a good night.
Hope y'all enjoyed it.
Alright.
Yeah.
Good night, y'all. Peace out.